Hello. Welcome to KentCoarseKid episode 50. And it's a big one today. We're back down the YouTube blog, if you remember this from previous years. I didn't do a video last year because I was pretty ill, but we're back down at the same venue again, which is Seven Lakes in Berkshire. Very kindly sponsored the event again. I will take you through who's fishing in a bit, but basically it's a match again, set over 48 hours. So we're going to have 24 on this lake, which is Lake 6, and 24 on Lake 7. The lake we're fishing right now is sort of a fairly standard rectangular looking lake that goes up there and down there, which is where George Day, Fenland Fisherman, and the barbecue is, so just to the right of us. It's one rod each for me and Leo. It's two rods per team because there's a couple of people fishing on their own, and so both myself and Leo have got a rod here. No, it's my Fox Rory and Leo's whatever he's gone for, dial or something or other, I think. My rod, it's just down on corn, maize, crumb, my favourite particle approach on the critically balanced corn rig down in the margin. And Leo's rod, because it's technically mine too, because he's on my team, is on the homemade honey boilies, which are hanging in the tree there. And that's just down in the margin here. We've gone for margins now. Because this is a new lake, we've never fished it before. I'll show you my bivvy there and Leo's bivvy there. Tends to be a good idea with new lakes you've been fishing to go for the margins, because they're an obvious spot, especially if you don't know. You know, there's obviously a fair few features. There's a, don't know what that is, sort of island aerator type thing out there. But because we don't know the bottom of the lake, because it's a, you know, it's a 24-hour match and it's a social, we're not really going to be leading around and marker floating and stuff to find what the bottom of the lake's like. Margins are very often a good bet to start with a new lake. So we've got both in the margin. If by around about, I don't know, sort of 7-8 o'clock tonight, we haven't had anything when the barbecue is, what we'll do is we'll put one of them maybe into more open water, maybe make a bit of effort and find a spot. But for now, both rods in the margin. I've already had one catch while Leo's been over talking to Carl and Alex, and that's that twig there. Carl, Alex and Leo are over in peg one, which is over there. There's a very blurry Carl doing some, I believe, surface fishing. I'll take you around and meet some of the other blogs who are here as well. So, yeah, that's the video. I'm going to put the cricket back on because it's England-India, the final test. And, yeah, I'll see you in a bit. So, England doing well, beating India again. I think they're about 25 for 3 for anyone that watches cricket. So we're doing very well indeed. I thought I'd give you a quick idea of who's around the lake. We've got Carl and Alex over there. Sure you know their blogs. We've got Dan Jones from Carp Course in Swansea. He's been a regular at the match. He's been here all 3 years, one of the originals, with myself and Leo and a couple of others. Chris Carp King Fennel, he was here last year. Sure you will know his blogs. Simon Taylor and his mate there. I'll come around the corner a bit more. We've got Fenland Fisherman over there. Who's this? Joker. Unfortunately, who's got to be my teammate?
Was that you? What do you mean, unfortunately? I'm a great teammate. What are you talking about?
I don't know.
I'm a great fisherman.
The other time we were fishing, the other week, he goes to bed. We're fishing the Wild Lake. You might see a video of that sort of towards the end of this summer, but he's fishing the Wild Lake. Wake up in the morning. He's, you know, sound asleep as always, about 10 o'clock in the morning. And I've been up since 8, and I'm wondering why his rods haven't got off, because he's put them in some nice little spots we've been pre-baiting. And I go over and look at his alarms. Neither of the rods are going through the alarms, are they, Leo?
Well, it's an easy mistake to make, really.
And one of them had had a bite on, and the lead had been dumped in the middle of the lake. Yeah.
Oh, well,
Muppet.
These things
happen. Senor Muppet.
These things happen.
What's German for Mr.?
Air.
Air Muppet over here. Now then, let's just hope one of these rods screams off and we take the lead. Have you spoken to George or to Carl and Alex about the stamp of fish in this lake? Do you know what?
I've spoken about stamp of fish, but Carl and Alex, well, Alex caught a 3 pound 4 ounce common.
Did he?
He did.
I didn't know that. What, off the surface? Cheeky bastard.
Oh, that's right.
Off the mark already. There's
first
Dan.
First carp of the lake.
Putting some mistral bait out. Is that the first carp?
First carp of the mountain, yeah.
Fair enough.
A couple of roach down there.
Mm. As you'll see, I've just bought a few bits and bobs inside because it did start to spit down
now
for a second.
Like a blue sky.
Yeah, and now it's sort of got a bit nicer again, so it's mugging me off really. But Yeah, I've only got three batteries for 48 hours, and these batteries usually last about 20 minutes apiece, so I'm going to have to ration them a bit. So, yeah, I'll go around and speak to a few more people in a bit and say hello, but basically, until then, we'll just hope one of the rods rolls off and
double hook up.
Leo goes off and leaves us in peace.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Right then, it's about 7 o'clock in the evening now. Reason you haven't seen me for a while is because pretty much around this side nothing's happened. I've been asleep for a few hours. I was listening to the cricket, and the cricket sort of sent me to sleep, as it often does. And I only had a couple of hours sleep last night, so yeah, I've nodded off. Leo went to Sainsbury's with a couple of the other guys, got a few bits and bobs. There's been a few fish caught. Dan Jones over there, one of the originals, had a 9-pound common, which I saw before I went to sleep. Apparently, since then, there's been a few fish out along that far bank, but nothing bigger than that. So the one fish I saw is still in the lead, which is all right. And all along this bank's been really quiet. So we're all going to go for a nice social barbecue in a minute. And the rods will be reeled in, I think, for at least an hour or so. You see George and everyone getting it going there. We'll go over there in a sec. But yeah, hopefully, George is a Fenner fisherman, if you don't know him. His idea was that this is the deeper end of the sort of the deeper side of the lake, and perhaps the fish are over there in the shallower side. And maybe in the night, if it gets cool, which I have no idea of the forecast because I broke my phone, then the fish will move into the deep water over here, and we'll have to wait and see. So who knows? The left-hand rod, which, as you know, is on a boilie, we may change that to a plastic overnight because a few people have had a problem with crayfish. Not especially big problems, but, you know, the sort of winding the boilies in, it's been fairly seriously nibbled. And the right-hand rod's already on a plastic down there, so... Well, it's a lovely evening, really, and it's lovely spending time with all these bloggers who we get on with so well. But a couple of fish in the night would maybe be all right. Move over down here. George, one of the originals, we worked out there's only actually a few of us that were here since the first year, 3 years ago. It's myself and Leo, George Day, Mark Erdwin, who is not actually fishing this blog, this session, but he's been around and about.
He's alive!
Yeah, I'm alive. And Dan Jones was there, and Carl and Alex were there, so a few of the originals. It's George's rods.
The
whole thing, go, keep going.
And then when it goes back up the stream into the bottle, it explodes.
Yeah, telling me.
So last year you burnt the sausages, and this year you're planning not to do the same.
Oh, shall we? Is that too close to that by any chance?
No, it'll be alright.
As long as it doesn't suddenly go ridiculously windy and blow the whole plane into that.
Be fine.
Then we're fine.
On the sauce tonight.
Hello, mate.
Hey, Dan.
Someone's in our chair.
In your chair.
Carl.
All right.
Chair.
Yeah, on your feet, lose your seat.
It's my chair. My personal chair. What's he doing? Big selfie.
I heard
oh, perfect. Right then, so night has fallen on the annual YouTube bloggers match for the first night. Yeah, basically both rods recast, both rods ready to go. One in the margin on pop-up corn, and one in the other margin on pepperami. So. Yeah, it's been in bed for a couple of hours. I've just, after having a chat with some of the other guys, come to bed, get the boys inside, keep them wet. Keep them wet, doesn't make any sense, keep them dry. Yeah, we'll see you. See you hopefully in the night with a fish, but if not, in the morning. Morning all. Quite a night for me, quite a night for Leo. Team KentCoarseKid and Token German is still on zero. Everyone along this bank actually didn't catch anything. I think George maybe down at the end had one, sort of a 3-pounder. But yeah, it would appear this bank is pretty average. There's Michael blanking away as well, having a cup of tea. Carl and Alex are in the lead with a, I think it was just under 10 pound mirror over in that corner. And we're gonna redraw swims for the second lake in about an hour, so.
All right. I've got to film with two cameras at once, this is difficult.
Oh, you're an expert, Cody, do it for a living.
Okay.
So here it goes, KentCoarseKid's first fish of the match. Yeah. And it's...
suddenly got Tourette.
Okay, KentCoarseKid, first fish of the match, and it's this big, beautiful, fully plated mirror. I think it's gone 6-7, I believe.
Not really big.
It's pretty deep, I think it's about the fifth or sixth biggest fish of the match. And realistically, who cares when they look like this? There's a bite over there. It's all kicking off down here at Seven Lakes.
Yes, it really is.
And here he is. Dark, fully scaled mirror that puts us, I think, in about fourth place. So, safe. Let's get him back.
Don't mention my phone going in there.
Safe.
Right, someone do a photo for me.
I'll do a photo.
Yeah, go.
Right, well, I'm fishing a simple bolt clip set. There's no leader on here. Just using the straight mainline. Straight to a probably about 10-inch braid hook link. KD rig. With Jaffa Cake and a pepper on there. Let me just take a picture of it and then I'll show you where I'm fishing to.
Hey, up.
It's Dobby. Oh. And his camera.
Beautiful. That's right. One for Instagram.
Should we whack this out 100 yards?
Yeah.
I haven't picked up, and there's a very nice overhanging tree.
Give me a minute, I'm not filming. Now I am.
It's really good, it goes soft in the water.
Yeah, but don't back it too much.
Love it, it's really mushy.
Oh,
that's so
big impact.
That's a tactic, mate. Yeah, this is the moment where the 40 takes it.
Right, fish number two. Haven't got it on the scales yet, but it might go double, beat the lake record that we've got so far. Don't know. Feels chunky. Little common. Left hand rod, obviously, is my only rod again. Pop up corn. Pretty simple. I missed the run again. That's 5 out of 6 runs I've missed. So, professional carp angling all round. Let's get it back.
Hello and welcome to KentCoarseKid. That's the most annoying thing.
Are you filming?
Yes.
Here we have.
So here it is. It's not the biggest in the world.
Yeah, it is. It's huge.
It's come off the recasted rod this morning, which you'll find all about in George Day's blog, Fenland Fisherman. But I do have the honour, I assume, at 9:59 of having the last carp of the match. So it's my last carp. That's 4 now. Not the biggest, as I said, but lovely fish all the same. Let's get it back and go home.
Make a nice pike bait, that one, I think.
Well, I'd say so. A few trebles.
Yeah, lovely.
No, he's not happy about that.
Where did George?
The man, the legend, the carp king.
I'm in my mum's car.
Boot
nookies.
It's just the end of
Oh, have you not seen your house? I'm in my mum's car.
Why'd you have a massive bike?
Get out of the car.
Oh, yeah. No.
I watched it about 50 times.
Yeah.
Oh, here on hashtag German watch, we see a German in his natural environment strapping rods to the roof with the faces of a monkey.
Is your camera waterproof?
My what?
Why is it in the rain?
Oh, we've lost a German. They get spooked very easily.
My one doesn't take any rain.
So, everyone want to get their close-ups?
I'd stand back a bit.
Yeah, but Alex
can
do the explosion after the fifth bump.
Nice.
Yeah, you've
got
to hang it time
position. Right, everyone here? No, Dan's not here.
He's there.
Covered
the trophy.
There you go, we'll show
you.
Right,
let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Ow.
Sorry.
See you later, guys.
See you later. Nice to meet you.
Snagged on fish here.
Snagged on fish. Everyone look at that.
Yeah, look at that channel.
Fishing.
Yeah, snagged on fishing. Fishing.
Don't look at it, it's rubbish.
Pair of bell.
Go. Thank you. See you next time.
No, me wallet.
I'm up now, there's wallet.
No, get out. Room. Get off me wallet. Right. Here we go. Leaving the YouTube Bloggers Match 2014. It's sad to go, but quite want to get home and watch Liverpool versus Southampton, first game of the season. Close that window, and we'll be on our way. In the end, I think Team Kent Course had 6 fish. I had 4, Leo had 2. Biggest we had was about 6.5 pounds, that lovely fully scaled mirror. Leo didn't make a blog because it was a match for the best blogs in the United Kingdom.
Yeah,
does his blog make that? Does it? No.
I didn't.
So.
Nearly did that.
We're off home, it's about, 2 hours?
Yeah, pretty much, depending on traffic.
Yeah, decent. And, thank you to Seven Lakes for hosting us for the last couple of years. It's been good fun. I don't think we'll be back again, so thank you very much for the last couple of years.
Yep, thank you.
The fish are absolute stunners. If you're ever in the Berkshire area, you want to get down and do a bit of fishing and catch some absolute almost wildies. There are some proper nice fish in these lakes. They are a bit snaggy, but you know, can't have everything, and it's part of the wildness of the lake. So yep, here we go. I think this is pretty much the exit here, and cheers to everyone else who attended. Nice to meet you all again. Some of you, I'm talking to sort of to Tom Warren, didn't particularly enjoy meeting him. Carp King, always not a pleasure.
Dangerous.
Who else are we not fans of?
Dobby.
No, can't hurt Dobby. Thank you to George Day for organising it. We will see you very shortly, or probably not.
Know
my blogging, but yeah, see you in a bit.